let's take the 16th question. That is, there are n number of charges q to q n q, so on n q, on the circumference of a circle of radius r. So if there is a circle of radius r, then there are n number of charges q to q, so on n q. So they are asking, find electrostatic potential at the center. What is the electrostatic potential due to a point charge at any distance kq by r? So here the electrostatic potential is kq by r, right? So all charges are positive, so all the potentials are positive. If there is any negative charge, then the potential is negative. So this is the one single physics formula. So it is related to which chapter? Electrostatics. What is the concept? Electric potential. Let's say, what is the total potential at the center? Due to one charge, the potential is kq by r. Because all charges are on the circumference. From the center, each charge distance equal to radius. So kq by r, k2q by r, k3q by r, so on. K n q by r. So in each term, k q by r is same. Take it out. So 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus so on n. So it is like sum of natural numbers. So sequence and series. So if you take that one, then n into n plus 1 by 2. So k q by 2 r. This is the total electric potential at center. But for the same situation, they can also ask you another question, like, if another charge is placed at center, and what is the work required to move it to infinity? Or they can also ask you in the other manner, what is the work required to move the charge capital Q from infinity to the center? Either work required to move from center to infinity or from infinity to center. What is the work done formula? Work done equal to charge whatever you are moving through potential difference. So what is the potential difference? Final potential minus initial potential equal to charge into. What is the final potential? You are moving to infinity. At infinite separation, no interaction. No interaction. So what is the final potential? Zero. What is the initial potential? Already we calculated n into n plus 1 k cube by 2 r. So that what is the work done will become minus n into n plus 1 k cube by 2 r. So wherever questions are given related to potential, they can also ask the question related to work done. Because potential difference between two points is nothing but work done in moving the charge between those two points per unit charge. Or if you want to find potential at a point, you need to take work done per unit charge. What should be that work done? Work done in moving from infinity to that point. So here you have to find the work done in moving a charge from one point to infinity. So final potential minus initial potential. So charge times potential difference equal to work done. So to find work done, you need to find potential difference. To find potential difference, you need to find potential. Initial potential and then final potential. So this is how you can understand the question and you can solve the concept. Please understand. Then apply physics together with mathematics. Thank you.